UFC back on Fight Island October 30th. UFC 267, a pay-per-view, Luke, that you don't have to pay for. A little bit of a
just
good,
a per-view. A
little bit of a great deal right there. And how about the happiest fighter in the entire world, Brazil's own Amanda Ribas, who will be back on that card in Abu Dhabi against Virna Jandiroba. Big fight for Amanda. But before we talk about that, Amanda, can you just give us your secret to successful living and being that happy and joyful, please? Share it with us.
Oh my goodness. I don't know what to say. I just like to enjoy, you know, because sometimes when you don't enjoy what you do, you just do with the bad vibe. And
yeah, that's my co-host. I know that feeling.
So I all the time try to put my best vibe on what I'm doing. But it's not all days I'm like this. But I try.
Well, you're one of the best women's flyweight fighters in the world. But you do have some questions to answer entering this fight because of that loss to Marina Rodriguez. A stoppage defeat could be a huge turning point in the arc of your career. How do you respond to that emotionally and physically in terms of what we're going to see in this fight coming off your first major defeat like this?
Yes, I was in my last fight. I think I learned a lot because we can't stop. If you stop, the perfect punch find your face and is killed. So that happened with me and I learned this. I can't stop in the fight. I can't stop in the life. So because against Marina, I was winning the fight and then she threw the perfect punch. And then I lost the fight and she did great. She did the perfect punch, like I said. And after that, in all my camp against Angela, I was focused on that and always trying to do something. And my heart was like, yes, I want to fight again. I want to show that emotion again that I love to fight. And that fight against Angela, I did against COVID too. So now I am really prepared because I want to fight, guys. Really, imagine that you lost your last fight and after that COVID. And now, no, now I'm going to Fight Island again. And I'm going to fight, to show my fire eyes, because I think that is my differential.
Look, the fire eyes are back.
I can see that for sure. Hey, Amanda, just to clarify, when you talk about what went wrong against Marina Rodriguez,
the crazy hair too. Look, this. Oh my god.
the hair is wonderful. In talking about the Rodriguez fight, just one more question about that. Are you saying you didn't stick and move enough? You didn't show enough motion. Is that why you lost?
I think I stopped it. And in a fight against a kickboxer, a striking person, you can't stop. Because if you stop, she will take the distance. And she find the distance. At the moment that I stop it, she find the distance. And she throw the perfect punch. So I learned that.
All right, so Amanda, you were supposed to fight Angela Hill in early June. Early May, and then it got rescheduled to early June because of COVID. But then even in June, the fight got canceled because I guess you were still dealing with it. What were the symptoms that prevented you from fighting in the second time the Hill fight was booked?
Yes, that in COVID, I did two times. And the first time I did COVID, I didn't feel nothing too bad. But the second time, I feel really bad. My nose, I didn't breathe, my mouth. I tried to walk and not so really bad. My skin, look this, my skin was like in the fire and my skin was warm and not good feeling. And after that, I did a lot of exams and still with something in my organism. And I did some medicines and now I'm feeling really great. I'm not feeling nothing, thank God. because COVID is crazy. There is some people has some symptoms and others don't feel nothing, but now I am good.
Okay.
That is great to hear, absolutely. I wanted to ask you, look, so you grew up the daughter of a accomplished martial artist himself and your father and coach Marcelo. Was it always automatic for you that you were gonna go into the fight game? Was that something that just became natural in terms of growing up and that's what your dad did?
Yes, this is good because it's, for me, it's natural. There is a time in my life that I didn't fight. I just did dance and study. And I think in that part of my life was so calm, so not good for me. I think I like this, the challenge after challenge. And because the fighter life is too crazy. It's not like just one way, just one vibe. It's always like, and I like that. I like the, when I think the life will go in this way and then change, I like that. So for me, it's good. It's natural. Like,
that's the same way I host the show, Luke, just so you know.
Yes, right? Believe me, I'm well aware. The dance you were studying, what type of dance were you studying?
Yes, I did ballet. I did jazz. I did like just that dance you do like woo, woo, woo.
Belly dancing.
I forgot the
belly
name. Dancing. I just know it in Portuguese. Dança do ventre. In English, I don't know. Yeah.
Like, now, Amanda, I read a quote. I read a quote of yours on Wikipedia. Tell me if it's true, where you said when you gave up fighting to go into dancing, it was the worst time in your dad's life and he wanted to die. Is this an actual quote from you about this?
For my dad, I think he didn't like it because imagine his daughter was so good fighter and then she stopped to fight just to dance. He was in my... when I do the dance for the people, my presentation, he all the time was there, of course, taking pictures, but I think in his heart, my daughter, she is a fighter, a truly fighter, so she needs to come back to fight. And now I think he is more happy.
Well, he's so happy, Luke. I need to point out one of the greatest moments in fathering history here, that your father got a tattoo of your first UFC appearance, what, on his forearm of you putting the choke for your first victory against Emily Whitmire, excuse me. I've celebrated that tattoo because that's a strong dad move right there, okay?
It is a strong dad move.
I'm not a girl dad, but I would do that for my sons, okay? I'm telling you I would do that. What did you feel like when you saw that? Did you know he was going to do that? Was that a big surprise?
No, he said to me he was doing a tattoo, and that is not a representation for me. Like, who? My baby daughter. No, it's a representation of his life. Because here in my city, I think, and a lot of cities too, the MMA fighter was looking like a bad guy, not good guy. And I think that first victory, I can show to everybody that we are not bad guys. And we do a true work, a good work, taking people off the streets and going to the gym and do your best. And here in a small city, we can beat the world. So for me, that tattoo symbolism that, because my dad, since I know myself, he is a fighter, vale tudo fighter. So for me and for him too, that is a tattoo like represent his goal in his life, not my baby daughter.
Look, if we could just get your dad to watch this show once.
Maybe he'd get a forearm tattoo?
Maybe he would get a
forearm. I don't think he would. I don't think I have that kind of a dad. Real quickly, before we sort of transition to the fight that you have coming up, there is a flyweight title fight, or excuse me, I should say a strawweight title fight coming up at UFC 268. Rose and Weili Zhang, I'm not sure you pronounce it correctly, but in either case, who do you like in that one and why?
Oh my goodness, I really want to fight this fight because I like Yang, but I love Rose. I don't know why I never talked to her, but she seems to be a really good person. And I like his style in fight. And for me, I think she will win again. I hope so. But because I think she is a truly fighter. Like, it's not a bad person. It's not for me. The champion needs to be not just the champion in technicals or inside of the octagon. I think need to be a good example. And in my mind, for me, Rose is. So I'm sending good vibes for her.
All right, and speaking of your upcoming opponent, and if I pronounce her name wrong, please correct me, but the best I can do is Virna Jandiroba, something like that. What is your number one challenge in that fight?
I think my challenge is to be calm, because sometimes I am too accelerated with a lot of energy and don't think. So I need to be calm, because Virna, she is really good on the ground, but she is working a lot her box. So I need to be careful of that too. And she showed that against Mackenzie and against the Japanese fighter. So I need to be careful with that too. And that's it.
Can't wait to check it out. UFC 267, the preliminary main event. It's Amanda Ribas. Best of luck to you. Thank you so much for the time. Keep that smile. We love what you're doing.
Thank you. It's a really pleasure to be here talking to you guys. Thank you for this opportunity. And I hope you, everybody, sending a good vibe for me and for Brina to do a great fight in UFC Fight Night.
We certainly do. Thank you so much, Amanda.